She was a pretty thing, with her blonde hair cut into a fringe across her forehead, and the rest plaited into two fat little pigtails. She had a rosy, cherubic face and large light blue eyes, and Amy had to admit that Susie dressed the child beautifully now that she had the money to do so, and always saw to it that she was spotlessly clean. Today, Becky wore a blue and white gingham smock dress, covered by a frilled white pinafore with white cotton stockings and neat brown shoes. Amy remembered how she and the others, including Paddy, had always gone barefoot in the summer, and thought there were advantages in being the spoilt youngest of the family when the older children had all grown up. But she didn't grudge Becky her boots or pretty clothes, and was just glad for the child's sake that both Bill and Susie clearly adored the little girl.
Amy?
Becky shook the hand she was clasping impatiently.
Shall I wait for the next tram, or can we go home? I didn't really want to come up to meet Mary all that much, because I don't know her very well. Not nearly as well as I know you. Besides, she's staying for a week this time, and I dare say you've only popped in to have tea with us. So shall us go home, Amy? The boys are home, of course, though Gus usually goes out of a Sunday. Oh, Amy, did you know Gus has fallen out with Peggy Higgins, and they've been going steady for 3 years? Longer?
Well, I never, Amy said, as the two of them, hand in hand, began to walk up Crosby Road. Mind you, people do fall out from time to time, you know. It's probably what they call a lover's tiff, and in a few days they'll be going steady again.
They won't, though,
Becky said positively, swinging vigorously on Amy's hand.
Peggy's got a little sister what's only 2 years older than me, and she says Peggy don't care for Gus no more. She's got a fella who ships aboard the Devoner, what goes regular to India and the Far East. Ellie, that's Peggy's sister, says he brung back a china tea set for Peg, with little cups like eggshells, all painted with pagodas and such. She says Gus never give Peggy nought but the odd bag of shrimps.